It's time to beat that beat up. What is up, guys, and welcome back. Today we have a really cool project. We have a 116-year-old coal/wood-burning stove that we're gonna restore back to its beautiful original condition. This stove is a barn find, and I can't believe the shape. It's rusted up and stuff a little bit. Everything's there, everything's perfect. Every bolt screw is accounted for. Can't beat that. Just real quick, before anybody gets into wood stoves are better than this, or pellet stoves are better than that, whatever. It's wood or coal. Usually it's used for coal. I just want this for every once in a while. I have an electric heated house, but if the power goes out, if I just want to save a little money with some firewood, throw it in there. Let's take a look at the stove.
There is the stove. This thing is really, really old. It's got this really cool ornate thing on top to keep anything from like jumping up on there or putting their hand on there and accident. It's got the original temperature bar thing where you grab that, you don't have to get burnt. Pull that off. Get inside there in a second. Come down to the front of it and you open the door. Everything's there. All the heat, hardware and all that. All of these still function. And it's got a date of 1906. That's an old stove. 116 years old. Can't believe the condition it's in. Everything's there. Every bolt. The original pan is in it. Perfect. The original grate. The original shaker. I don't know if this thing just hasn't been used or just stayed in a magical little spot in that barn. When you go over to the side, there's a little, it's a flap there, and all that original shaker stuff still works. Pull out this lever and it moves that shaker in the bottom and lets the coal fall. When you pull the lever out from the side, it pulls this shaker down here over and lets the coal ashes fall through. First step to restoring this bad boy and having this look like a beautiful antique is to sandblast it. And I am stoked because I just got a sandblaster and I never used one before. So let's go on a journey. To run the media blaster, we will need an air compressor. This is the one I'm using here. I got it plugged in and on so it keeps pressure in the tank. And I've got a couple hundred feet of hose all the way out to the front porch. The media blaster recommends 80 PSI. I went ahead and I put mine on about 87 because I've got 200 feet of hose. It's got to go through at all times. Just raise it a hair. The media blaster I'm using is a 90-pound Black Bull. It's a siphon feed and it's going to hook to the air compressor right at the gun. Cannot forget safety material. I got the hood, dust mask, and it came with replacement tips. Again, I'm not sure how often I'll have to replace those. I'll keep you guys posted. And then the media we're going to blast it with, I got Black Diamond brand. You can pick this up in fine or in medium. Let's load it up and let's get it on. If you're gonna burn coal, there's different sizes of coal. There's stove coal, pretty big, nut coal, which I prefer, down to pea coal, and there's some other kinds there. The smaller they get, the quicker they'll burn, but the easier they are to light. Bigger they get, longer they last, harder they are to light. Right in the middle, that nut coal, try that one. It's about $5.50 for 50 pounds. Thank you. You can see how well that media blast has taken everything off. If I concentrate too much, it comes right down to the metal, which is really good, but I don't really need that. Looks really nice. I just need to take it and get it down to where this roachy stuff, this real thick textured stuff, is off there. Then I'll be ready to paint. I gotta get the camera back because this stuff's gonna ruin the camera. Again, you can see where all that thick textured rust is coming off. That's what I'm looking for. Thick textured rust right here, all came off nice and smooth and pretty now. This stuff is real smooth, don't have to worry too much about that. I'm gonna keep going around hitting all the rest of it, and we'll move on. I found while sandblasting that this here is either aluminum or maybe it's been chromed or something at one time. So I'm going to take that paint off and use that as an ornamental piece.
Time to go put it in, but I wanted to tell you guys real quick first, my next video is going to be really cool. It's going to be how to make a fan that uses no electricity, just runs off the heat with two motors on it. I'm going to break down an old computer and build one of those step-by-step how-to. There's other videos of them on here, but not many that walk you through how to do it yourself step-by-step. So make sure you subscribe and check back to see that one. It's going to be pretty freaking cool. This right here is the area I want to go in with the stove. You can see there's already an existing 6-inch hole there, goes through a chimney. So that part should be easy. Gonna put a stove board down, protect the wood, and the house from fire. We have to fit this pipe together, snaps right in. Now I'm gonna put the damper in. Push this in. Rotate it around, pull it out. I want that up toward the top up here.
I love the lighting in the back.
There we go. Top is oval, so I'm gonna have to kind of bend that over. So, here we go. I'm gonna go with another 1-footer. R90. Finally, the last horizontal piece. Whenever you do horizontal, make sure that your seam is on the bottom because the smoke's going to ride the top.
A bead of this high temp caulk. And last but not least, there she is, ready to go. Completely restored, Gotta get those stupid tags off the piping. But don't need to put that in video. Put that little thermostat on there.
Hey guys, that's all I got for today. Hopefully you liked the video. If you did, make sure you leave a like, comment, subscribe. If you didn't, make sure you check out the people on the bottom of my channel. I got cool people down there under Bad Mofos. Keep in mind, if you subscribe, you'll get notifications for the next videos. It'll pop up on your screen somewhere up there. Hey guys, thanks again for watching. Take care. Later. Peace.